takes F3. Oh, what is going on? Oh, this is going to be a fortress. I just don't see any hopes at all. This is very easy. Just rook back and forth.
Taking chess to the next level.
Wow. Wow.
Wow, yeah. Nothing else to say. Wow.
Creating the future of the sport. Introducing the Champions Chess Tour. 10 months, 10 tournaments. The world's best players online and on TV.
Hello everyone, today I will play Banter Blitz against you guys, so okay, let's accept the challenge. Yesterday I played Polish Banter and was like willing to play this kind of openings with white, with the aim of playing rook g1, g4, g5 whenever possible. Now I will just do the same, hopefully, once he castles. Yeah, but he is reluctant of doing this. All right, rook g1 might be actually quite slow here because of e5, so I will just gamble with g4 immediately. I assume that taking on g4 is like the most critical here. I have started with h4 actually as well. Oh, but knight df6 is an odd move to me, because after h3 he will have to play knight h6, and the knight must be put in a very bad spot there. So actually f5 I think was a worthy alternative, apart of knight gf6 obviously. Okay, how about playing knight e2, knight f4? Just to increase the pressure. Now I'm pretending that I do have the compensation for the pawn. I'm not sure it's really the case, but it's of no importance. Like, I mean, in human's game, there is always some play in the position against the computer. I guess it's close to lost already, but Have one nice idea of playing knight f4, knight h5 here. Yeah, actually after knight h5 there might be d4, so I assume I would have to take on f5 first and then go knight f4. Okay, let's play it immediately. Actually, I'm wondering how black can prevent this. Maybe king h8, but it would be a very awkward move to play. So, yeah, and now I think I'm close to winning. Okay, cbab, I guess. Yeah, actually, I don't have to take anything yet, just b takes c4. You can't really do a thing here. Okay, now he might threaten to take on h5 with the pawn. Actually, knight g5 is the move here as well. Because after g takes h5, there is knight takes h7, followed by checkmate, so... Yeah, I will play knight g5 for fun. Yeah, and knight takes h7 now. It's a killer. Okay, so that was quite a nice game. Yeah, we'll play g6 using the fact that he can't get this Marocci structure anymore. Now it's just Grand Prix attack. But it should be pretty good version for black because yeah, I have omitted playing d6, which is kind of a waste of time, I think. I mean, okay, when you play the knight, you obviously can do a thing and have to play d6, but now it should be pretty good version for me, I believe. Actually, f5 might be a threat. I mean, sort of threat, because I can always play knight c6. Just castle. Knight c3 is natural. Actually, I want to play d6 f5 here. And I'm just gaining some space. King h8. Just prophylaxis. Now, when he played knight g3, gf might be not good for me, because there is always knight h5 in the air, so... Yeah, so that's why I played king h8, to have a possibility of recapturing the e-pawn. I think it's pretty comfortable for black. Not that black is better here, but... Okay, now I might... Okay, dc before was my idea, but now it's... obviously pointless, so Okay, now DC and b4, I think. Makes sense, or b4 immediately even. Yeah, DC, bishop c3, I think is... it's pretty good for him, actually. Okay, but let's go for it anyway. Maybe after bishop takes e3, there is move like e5. Okay, let's try this. Now I want to play b4 and knight d4. Actually, against pretty much everything, so... I can take on e5 here with knight as well. But okay, d takes e5 looks pretty good to me. Yeah, now before knight d4 is like the key idea here, so he can't really do much, I think, against it, so. And it's pretty unpleasant to meet. Okay, I thought this was impossible because of b4. And then d4. Okay, rook takes f5 is also an option after queen takes rook f8, but I think this is just simpler. Because in the end of variation, the one I mentioned, he could have taken on f8, so now I'm not trading anything and don't have to worry at all. Okay, now I'm just queen up. Yeah, that's, I miss bishop d1, but. Bishop b3. I miss as well, but being queen up should be good enough. Okay, so that was, I think, an interesting game. Actually, it went downhill very fast for white for some reason. I'm not sure where he made a mistake. Obviously, taking on f5 was a mistake, but it was already pretty unpleasant for him, so. So, okay, blunder panda this time. Let's play the French. AD would be unpleasant, actually. Somehow feel that he might go for it. Yeah, but knight c3 instead. Okay, let's play the Vinaver. Actually, it's some hybrid. I don't know exactly what this position is. Can go knight f5. Can play maybe king f8. Okay, let's play king f8. he wants to checkmate me, but knight e2. Let's play h5. I'm not sure it's so good for me, but actually I wanted to harass his queen. Thought that his queen would be in a worse spot than on g4. And f3 was interesting as well, with the threat of knight f4, knight takes e6. After that I would have played knight f5, of course, but rook g3 is, I think, a loss of tempi. Unless it makes sense to provoke knight f5, but I don't think so. Okay, now I can go cd. I can take on e2, but don't really want to take that pawn. Can play queen d8 just to... Yeah, I like queen d8 actually, because... Okay, it's probably not the most precise move, but I think it makes sense just to trade queens, not to be afraid of nothing anymore on the king side, and just rely on sort of positional edge. Okay, rook takes f5. That makes sense. Oh, I think king g8 is the move. The king g8, obviously there is e6. Yeah, e6, knight f6, knight f4. After knight f4, I have to play bishop c8, I think. That's not so clear. But queen e7 is probably even worse because of knight f4 and knight g6, so... Yeah, okay, I think I have to play like this. Oh, he surely has decent compensation here. Even materialistically speaking, it's not so bad for him. Maybe queen c8 is smarter. How about queen c6? Queen e8? Yeah, but now, after knight f4, I don't know how to protect the d5 pawn. That's kind of bad. Because obviously, I think I have to trade. Let's score bishops. Bishop b7, bishop b5 is pretty bad. Yeah, and now. Okay, maybe cd. After cd, he has knight takes d5. That's the problem. Not so simple. Okay, but I have to play something, so. Yeah, I wanted after knight takes d5 to play queen e6, but then under knight e7, queen takes e6, and knight g6 would be an endgame with two extra pawns for him, so. Yeah, but now this is my idea, and there is queen b5 check, so I kind of, yeah, get control on this in the center, so. Okay, assume some rook b1 will be played, or something like this. a6, I don't understand this move. Yeah, I think it's just a bad move. Let's have some fun. Some pawn grabbing. c7, no. Rook takes e6 might be. Okay, rook takes h3. It's here. Yeah, and now I'm trading queens, so I'm sure I'm winning. Like, with no issues. Okay, so that was, yeah, I misplayed it. Actually, queen d8 could have been bad, because of the rook takes f5, I think. Yeah, white has like pretty good position. Even though probably it's not better for white, but at least from the practical viewpoint, it was very unpleasant to play this with black because of this e6 and, yeah, the x-ray on the f line. Yeah, but he should have taken d5, obviously, instead of cd, and I would be in a very difficult spot. Yeah, let's play the Schlechter, the favorite weapon of many Chinese players. Actually, h4 is not the move here. Okay, now let's see. unless he wants to checkmate me, but he doesn't. So yeah, h4, h5 is too optimistic for sure. Yeah, now I'm just a safe pawn up. Obviously, there is this h4 line in Grünfeld, but the point is that white would have bishop on f4 rather than d2. So that makes a crucial difference, I think. And now let's play rook c8 with the idea of dc, c5. Cd, I guess I will play, just not to allow any e4 counterplay. Okay, that makes sense. So I will just read with the knight. Now, obviously, once he plays c5, the idea is to get to play e5. Yeah, now it's pretty bad for white. There is no even partial compensation for the sacrifice pawn. Right, 94. Just h5, there is no counterplay inside, even after g4, h takes g4. Yeah, he would need a queen to create some threats, but obviously it's close to impossible to do that. His queen is still being on c2. Now he might want to take on g6. Yeah, but I will just play e4, opening the bishop and stopping any sorts of ideas. Knife. Oh, just for fun a bit. Right, so. Yeah, this line used to be considered very, very topical, but lately, after f takes g3, the position seems to be not so good for black, actually, because it's likely that he will lack a plan. Yeah, obviously he can take on d4, but I will just castle, and yeah, I will have easy play on the king side with moves like knight g5, queen h5, and so on. So actually knight c6 would have been better, I believe, but yeah, but now I can even just play positionally, like even a 3b4 or something. Yeah, the pawn on d4 is obviously close to being lost, and I don't have to recapture it immediately. Yeah, but obviously I will focus my attention on the king side, so yeah, knight h4 is the move here. Knight c6, queen h5. Yeah, that looks very good to me. what's the idea after queen h5, just g6? Yeah, but g6, then bishop takes g6 looks very bad for him. I can play as well queen f3 after g6. Knight takes e5, queen f6, and that looks bad for him as well. Yeah, knight d8 is the move indeed. Okay, I can play a move like bishop g6, but then I think he will just play queen c7 and there are no more threats inside, so I will just grab. Yeah, create some targets on the queen side. It was like a4 before, potentially. Yeah, it's very, very strange to me that there is no direct way sacrifice, but yeah, but obviously once I play it slowly, like black has absolutely no moves here, that makes sense. Like there is no plan at all. So that's bad for him. Actually now g6 and then bishop b5 is the idea. But I think I will just play a5. Okay, a b. Now the bishop on descender. There is, I guess, a lot of tricks. Rg8 is the only move because f takes is met by bishop takes g6. Yeah. Let's take this bishop, I think, or maybe not immediately. Maybe bishop a5. No, fg, actually I blunder fg. Yeah, still queen take g6, queen h7 would be good enough for me, but now I think I'm just winning. King takes f7, knight h8, check, and queen f7, checkmate. Double check. Yeah, so as said, this position is very difficult to play for black. I mean, after this fg, which is kind of new discovery. I'm not saying obviously that black is lost or something, but still. It seems like self-playing position for white to me. Let's play e4 once more. This time I won't play c3. Let's play f3 just to sidestep the big theory obviously after bishop g5 or bishop c4. Yeah, this position is kind of strange because black seems to have like to be half tempi ahead instead of knight off with the pawn on a6 and knight still on b8, but actually this knight on c8 is not so on c6 is not so great for him. He would much rather be on d7 in some positions like bishop e6 and d7. So I5, what is this? I mean, it's a typical idea, but I think they don't play it here at the exact moment, so I can play knight f4. I think that's a pretty good move because d5, knight b6, d4, knight takes a8 is probably not enough for him. Yeah, and I just want to play knight f4 and c4 now, given the possibility. That's interesting. He doesn't mind giving away his light square bishop. Actually, he gains a lot of tempi after knight b6, rook b8, knight takes, rook c8. I have to recon with d5, so let's say c4, but then I don't know a4, knight d4, some counterplay on the dark squares. So I will just play c4 immediately. Yeah, there should be somewhat better for white here. It's like a good version of some Kawashnikov structures, where there is like all pieces are still present and yeah, black lacks space. Because usually this Kalashnikov, black manages to trade the square bishops, yeah, but now he doesn't, and that's an issue for him. Okay, so what to do here? Actually, it's not so simple for white to play as well, because I don't like my knight on b3, but knight d4 might be an issue one day. I will just play a3. That's kind of a strange move, but I want to play queen d3 and queen c2, not being harassed by knight c5. Okay, queen c2. Now rook c8 and b5. That's unpleasant, and actually queen c2 is like not a very great move. Yeah, but now I'm on time. Yeah, I need to play quicker because I'm in a difficult spot already, being 1 minute down the clock. A4 here is nice move. And now he blundered the knight. The question is if he resigns now or is just trying to outplay me on time. That's like me, so yeah, now I'm rook up. Just one. Obviously any moves would do it, like bishop a7, I don't know, gf even. Okay, so that was kind of lucky actually that he blundered his knight. And somehow I thought that it would be easier for me like to play, and but I struggled to find a plan. Okay, I need to take revenge against Upskitty, to whom I lost, I think in hand bane with Raquan. Okay, just Karukan, like this seven line maybe. Actually, I have never played it seriously, this line, so I'm just hoping that I won't get checkmated very, very early. C5. c5 and knight d7 is the line, but I think that with bishop on d3, not b3. What's wrong with queen takes d4 now? I don't see, so knight g3, but then just queen e4, knight bd5. I think this pawn sacrifice is unsound for him. Bishop b4 check was also the move. No, but then c3, bishop takes c3, and king f1, and I'm losing my bishop, so it's better that I played. Okay, long castle, knight takes e3, rook d4. It's not so simple, but now I think. Yeah, but now I think that that there is absolutely no compensation with such a weak pawn on e3. Bishop c5. Yeah, knight c4 is met by b5. Bishop takes d5 is close to resignation, I think, because now black has like everything. Everything is better in black's position. So, okay, bishop f5. I'm just aiming to trap the knight after f6. Okay, he doesn't fall. Yeah, now I wanted to blunder rook d4 myself, so one needs always to be careful. Rook b1 here. Yeah, but rook b1 still f6. Actually, I forgot already about this f6 idea. Yeah. Yeah, my d3 obviously is the move. Somehow I thought that I'm winning like the knight immediately, but obviously I do have too much pawns, so just bishop b4, defending everything. Bishop f3 and d4 is one idea that I will just play f4. No, queen takes, and this is winning because there is, bishop takes g2, knight takes g2 is obviously what I missed, but I actually wanted to be fancy with queen e1 first, but okay, it doesn't matter, I just will play queen c6, and okay, just not to, this king f7. Yeah, and now he blundered checkmate himself, so. Okay, so I took my revenge. Now time to switch d4. So the kid Yeah, I love playing this Zemish with white. I guess the idea is just to sidestep any fury that exists, and in this, not c5, I mean line, but in all other, just play for the quick checkmate with moves like bishop h6, h4, h5, and so on. But I will play g4 first. So e5, I want to play knight g2, keeping everything together, because after d5, knight d4 is unpleasant. And now I want to play d5. Okay, so he takes. Actually, it makes sense. Okay, now c5 is a threat. Bishop e2, bishop e2, then c5, and bishop e6. So, yeah, it's not clear if the play was so good. I mean, the g4 move. Okay, let's play. Let's still play it. C5, knight c2, I guess bishop e6. Yeah, but then I will probably go g5, f4, and f5. So we'll see. So double watch position. Ragging the King's Indian. Actually, I have this bishop takes e5 move here. Looks quite slow, but I think it. Yeah, it makes perfect sense because I want to just have the d4 square. Just want to play bishop d4, f4, and so on. Yeah, but now bishop d4 is mad, but bishop takes e2 and queen takes g5. I can play f4, I think. Yeah, f4 looks fine to me. Yeah, bishop takes e2, queen takes e2, knight c6. Actually, yeah, but then e5, and his bishop is in cage, so yeah, that's something. Because otherwise, I would be not on time with this bishop d4, but now. I think it's very good for white. I think he will have to sacrifice one day. Knight takes c5. Just to open up this bishop, but now knight takes c5 is met by rook d5, so. Let's play king b1. And now he might want to do this. Okay, we play rook d5 just in case. Now we have to be alert because after queen b6 there is knight d5 and rook takes c3. But just we play queen e3. I guess he won't trade the queens. Yeah, but queen c7 is not brilliant either because rook d1. Now rook d7 is a threat. Okay, knight a5 makes sense. I will just play queen d4. The idea knight c4, knight e3. Now my knight on c2 is the last piece I like, so trading it wouldn't be so bad. Can go knight a3 check, but I will just take on a3, I think. Takes e5 is also the move, but yeah, I would just take twice, I think. B5 is not the move I had anticipated, but they just straight and yeah, bishop e7 would be met by rook takes e7, I think. Rook d8 now. Not allowing him to double on the B line. Yeah, now. Okay, just anything is good. It's h5, f5. Right, so I plug him. Obviously, my position was winning anyway, so. Let's play the kid, modern, I don't know. Depends whether he will play for or not, but now it's just actually the hybrid of kid and modern. Yeah, but e87 is the line. Maybe not so great for black, but at least something different in comparison to the standard kid. f5 is the move, I think. Now we have, after ef, there is a little trap. Bishop takes d4. Bishop takes d4, bishop takes d4, knight takes f5, and there is no good way to protect his dark or bishop. Black is not better, but he's the one, yeah, playing for something more than equality, so. Okay, now I can take bc actually, but maybe it's better, I don't know. But bc, bishop d4. Okay, now I think c6 looks more natural, but then ef. Yeah, such positions are considered to be a little better for white. But f3 is not the move I like because of f4. I start my own. Yeah, so typical for the kid side attack. Actually, also wondering about taking on c3 once he allows it. Obviously, he doesn't, so. Yeah, now there are two ways, knight d5 and just g5, g4, or bishop e5. They like more. Yeah, just cementing this d6 pawn. Even when he plays c5 and c takes d6, I mean, when he's allowed to, still it's not so bad after c takes d6 for black. I will just play b6. Okay, a3 b4 is pretty slow. After a3, there might be some knight a5 or something. Now g5 g4 isn't the idea, but first I will play rook f7 with the idea of sidestepping with the queen to evade after queen e1 or something. Okay, b5. I don't quite understand this move. What after? He's gonna do after a6. Yeah, knight d4 obviously. Yeah, knight d4 would be. Yeah, would be good to spot it beforehand. Yeah, but still, it's anything but bad for black. Okay, he just wants to trade everything. Okay, so let's trade. Play a5. Yeah, white is solid enough. He. It's not really worse. And I don't like this move a3. It allows me to play a4. Actually, a4 might not be necessary, but I think it's pretty difficult to attack this pawn on a4 with this pawn being on c4. So, okay, g5, king f6. I mean, king f6, king e5, rook a5 first. Yeah, this is slightly better for black, I think. Still pretty solid for white, but okay, king f6. Yeah, he wants to put his king on c3, that makes sense. Yeah, but I'm just planning to play g4. Okay, H5. Rook G7, slowly improving. And G3 is met by H4, and the kingside is blocked forever. I don't want this to happen, so. And now I can play Rook A5 in the worst case, or Bishop D7. I think I would play. Just not to. Well, Rook D5 is just a mistake, I think. Yeah, but might be not so easy to break this. Okay, GF. H3 now, it's mandatory, yeah. Yeah, but I think that, yeah, it's actually interesting, but it can't be that bad for black. I mean, it would be much more dangerous with if he still has the rook, I think, but yeah, but actually it's not so easy either. Yeah, that's unexpected. Okay, I will just play rook e8. I don't like this move, but obviously I'm the one in control here, pressing, but rook c3 is total nonsense, like king b7. I wanted to play king d4, king c5, but it's like totally senseless move. Yeah, so now I'm actually might be in danger. Some danger. I will play here. Yeah, but I think I'm just winning on time, so that helps. Yeah, actually I misplayed it totally. Yeah, but luckily. Yeah, so this rook d5. Now it's very, very strange actually that. Yeah, but the position was so blocked that my rook was kind of stuck. Yeah, I don't know, maybe I should have opened. I mean, played some d5 or something to open the position, some lines, but I don't know. I don't quite see it. Maybe h4 immediately was the move instead of g takes f3. After h4, h3, sorry, h4, f takes g4, h3. And then after g takes, yeah, I think that was the way. So rook h7 and f3. Yeah. Yeah, that was h4 immediately was important because I want to play h3 and there is like no stopping it. Okay, so. Yeah, so that was actually very, very difficult. Yeah, these setups are popular. Actually, usually white wants to get it in a slightly better version. Just when, for example, when black plays bishop b4, only then e4, because bishop on b4 is worse place than, I mean, on b4 than on c5. c5 square is a perfect one. Yeah, h5, h4, I don't know what's this, but actually, I don't think it's so great for white. Because after h4 he will never achieve f4 in a good version, so yeah, I mean this is very suspicious. And now I can just start my own attack. I don't have to. Actually it might be not so good. But okay, let's play it. G5 h4 is obviously the idea. Then can play d3 or something. Yeah, and actually I'm not sure how to proceed further. Yeah, because this pawn on g5 is also unpleasant. It kind of stops my queen to join the action, and yeah, the f6 square might be an issue one day once the g4 knight is gone. Yeah, g takes h4 is. Now I have a funny move, knight h2. I don't think it's so great. You can even, in some version, sacrifice the exchange, so. Yeah, I think that d3 first would be better, or d4. because h3 was not a threat because of bishop f3. And after hg, knight g3, he would be like a couple of tempi ahead in development. Yeah, and I don't like this d4 either. It's kind of makes sense, obviously, because he wants to speed up his development, but yeah, but he's not really doing it, and okay, no knight h2, knight c5, knight f3 or something. Okay, maybe just the simplest. Now knight on a4 is yeah. Not very good place, so that makes sense. Yeah, and with the pawn on d3, at least I would have to play like very precisely to compensation for the pawn. Now I'm just better both positionally and realistically speaking as well. I can take on e3 with the queen, but I would just play bishop e6. Now knight h2, h2 queen f6 is not a threat, but almost a threat. Obviously taking on e3 still the agenda, as well as knight h2, I think, h3. After that, when knight f3 would be very unpleasant to meet, or maybe, okay, maybe let's castle first. There is no need to rush. Yeah, it's totally hopeless for white. Bishop h3 with the idea of rook g4. The g2 bishop is too many times attacked, or maybe bishop takes g2 first. And only then rook g4. Yeah, I will just play king d8. Yeah, sure. All right, so now I will play the Grimfeld, I think. Yeah, I won't because he plays the London. Let's see C5. What he's gonna do after this. Okay, d takes c5, that's pretty challenging sideline, I think. Yeah, but I can't really recall stuff here. Queen a5, d takes c5, or knight a6. Okay, knight a6, assume e4 is the move here. Knight d2, knight takes c5 is very comfortable for black. Takes bishop b7. And the point is obviously that I will play d6 and play immediately, and his bishop on f4 is kind of stuck. I can play even e5 one day, and yeah, but knight h5 looks good. He blundered the pawn.